Hi friend, it's Ron from CamMastery.com, where you can go to learn how to make great videos with Camtasia. This is a free lesson Friday, which means you get a free lesson right from my Camtasia Mastery course. If you want to get the entire course, you can head over to CamMastery.com/store and pick up that course. Now, onto the video. We now want to talk about cursor effects. When we're talking about cursors, we're thinking about the mouse, the arrow that's on the screen. Technically, the mouse is the hardware and the cursor is the arrow or the pointing hand or whatever we see represented on our screen. So cursor effects are going to be how our viewers see that cursor as it moves on the screen. What's important to note here is that these cursor effects can only be applied to Camtasia recording files. I can only apply them to something that looks like this, which is a screen recording with a cursor, as opposed to something like this, which doesn't have a cursor on it at all. That's me in my video. So to make things easier, I'm just going to disable my video track, and I'm going to make sure that we can see our background nice and big. I'm going to expand that, and I'll take this up to 100% so we can see things easier. So right now you can see that the clip I have selected is a Camtasia recording clip. If I were to select audio, then that's different. I'm going to have different options here in my properties panel. Right now this is audio, so I see audio properties. But when I go to this clip, this recording, I see that I have options for the screen itself, but there's also a tab up here for audio and for the cursor. And so one of the things I can change right off the bat is the size of the cursor. So if it's difficult to see on this screen, I can bump the cursor size up to twice its size or even more, up to 5 times its size. Now that's a little ridiculous in this case, unless your viewers were watching on a smartphone, for example. Then you might want that cursor to be extremely oversized so it's easier for them to see. Now I don't need to do that, but maybe I do want it to be around 200%. Now as I'm dragging this, I can't get right to 200. It jumps from 197 up to 200 some. So I can just go in here and I can type 200% and press enter. And now I know that my cursor is exactly twice the size it was before. Another thing I can do here is I can hide the cursor by changing its opacity down to 0. So opacity is how opaque an item is. And so in this case, we want to make sure that we can see it 100% as opposed to only seeing it around 50%. So now it's somewhat transparent, or completely transparent, not at all opaque. And so I can take it all the way down to 0. So if you need to hide the cursor for some reason, maybe you were showing a video and you sneezed and it moved around, you know, just like jerked around the screen for a moment or something like that. What you could do is just, you know, take the opacity down for a while, bring it back up, and I'll show you how to do that in a little bit. But for now, if you need to hide it, you can bring that opacity all the way down to 0. Now we don't want to do that here. We want to look at cursor effects. So those are the most basic cursor effects, changing the size and how well we can see it. There are much more advanced cursor effects, and we can find those over here on the left in the Tools panel. I can click Cursor Effects, or I can use the U key on my keyboard. Here I can see that there are cursor effects of how things look around the cursor. I have options for what happens on the screen when I choose a left click, and what happens on the screen when I choose a right click. Now let's start by looking at these standard cursor effects, just how the mouse appears on the screen all the time. We have the option to put a highlight around it, and that is to put this colored circle around it. We can choose a magnifier, which will make things bigger right around the cursor, or we can choose a spotlight, which will dim everything outside of the cursor itself. So to make things more obvious, I'm going to choose the highlight. Now notice when I go to click this and drag it down that it's highlighting the tracks that I can drag this to. I can't drag it to my video down here. I can't drag it to an audio track or this background. I can only drag it to those Camtasia recording files. Now I'm not going to choose that just yet, because if I want this effect to be applied across all of these clips, what I'll do is I will right click the track and say select all media on track. Now when I drag it down to any one of these clips, it applies it across all of them at the same time. So a few things to note here. First, each of these clips now has this show effects option. So I can click that little arrow and it says, oh, this is the cursor highlight effect that you've added. Or I can click the down arrow and it hides it. So now every one of these tracks has this extra little piece that we can show. You can also note here that it didn't apply it to this clip because, again, it can't. It's not a Camtasia recording file. Now, let's look at our options. So here we only had scale and opacity to start. Now we have a new effect, and this is the cursor highlight effect. Here I can change the color. Maybe this yellow color is brighter than I want, or maybe my company's color is orange, and so I want to have an orange color to highlight. Or maybe you're on a lighter background. You're perhaps on something, a web page that has a white background, and so to highlight it, you need something that's a little darker, and that'll draw its attention. But we'll leave it at yellow for now because that's probably the easiest way to see our cursor. The next thing we can do is affect the opacity of the highlight. So we're talking about how much we can see through this circle. And maybe I want to increase the opacity so that it's very dark and I can't see anything behind it. Or perhaps it's too bright and I need to dim it down so that it can allow a lot more of the background through. And it depends on what you're trying to click on. It might need that detail, so you might want to drop that. But it was at 75%. Now, if I don't remember that, I do have this undo option. And if I just undo this, it'll restore back to the default, just like I could have on the yellow as well. We can change the size of the highlight. We can make it extremely large or even smaller than it was originally. And we can change the softness around the edge of that. So we might have zero softness where it's just a perfect circle, or we can dim just a little bit of the outside edge of this, or a lot of the edge if I want to go out even further. So if we wanted the effect to kind of ease in like this, where it highlights and then stays there for a while and then goes away, we can do that with these ease in and ease out options. Now, most of the time we don't want to use these for this cursor effect. We would just leave it on all the time. So it has a 0 second ease in and 0 seconds to ease out as well. Now, if I wanted to change this effect, if instead of the highlight, I wanted to see what magnify looks like, I'll put the mouse cursor somewhere else so I can see what the magnify will look like. There we go. So I can change this. I can grab this and drag it down to this clip. Or again, most of the time I would want to add it to multiple clips. So you can see now I've added both the highlight and the magnify. Now I wouldn't want to do that. I would only want to have one of these. And so I can click the X to close or to cancel the highlight and just use magnify. And again, I wouldn't want to go from highlight to magnify, most likely. But if you needed to change those cursor effects, you could. And this is what it looks like. See how it's magnifying what's directly behind it? And as that cursor moves, it will magnify different parts of the screen. Okay, and lastly, let's take a look at Spotlight. So I'll drag that down to this same clip. I'll remove the magnify option. And now you can see with Spotlight, it's just dimming everything else around it, and you can only see what is right around the mouse. And again, the reason we would do this is to really highlight for our viewers what it is that we're clicking on or where it is that we're moving to. That's the whole idea with this, is that cursors can sometimes be small, and if we're doing instruction, it's helpful for our viewers to be able to see that cursor more easily. Lastly, we can add those left click effects. So you might want to see a ring whenever somebody clicks, or you might want to see this ripple effect where it bends the background to make it look like a water drop in a pond or something. You can see this crosshairs, or a scope is what they call it. You can actually hear a sound. You can hear, and I'm not going to play it here, but it will make a sound when you click. That actually is a good one. You might want to add that as well to this with something like a ring. You know, they have this target and they have this warp. Now, most of the time, I don't choose to use these left click or right click effects, but if there is a use for you to highlight the left click or the right click in your instructional videos, then go ahead and choose those and drag those down to your TechSmith recording file. Now, I'll confess that I should probably use these a lot more than I do. Remember, the whole idea behind an instructional video or a training video is to help guide students in something. And when you have a click, it's helpful for that user or that watcher to see where you're clicking, and adding that effect will help them to see things easier.